discussed weather a little bit already. There are elements of temperature. One of the factors is temperature. How the temperature varies. Whether the temperature is low or high, that defines our weather. Okay. Second is relative humidity. Whether the air is humid, whether it contains the moisture, how much, whether it's low in moisture or very high content of moisture is being there in air, it defines the weather. Or the winds. How the winds flow. Whether they are very gentle or very fast, very strong winds are flowing. These all factors define weather. There are many other factors as well. For example, precipitation, that is the rainfall. Precipitation, that is the rainfall or the squalls or the fog. Those all comes in precipitation. Or how the clouds are being developed. Okay, these are components of weather. These all defines the weather at any place. Okay, so main two components we'll be discussing in this chapter. Main two components of weather, which are atmospheric pressure and wind. We'll be discussing these two components of weather. So first, we'll be confined to atmospheric pressure. Okay, we all know Earth, it is being surrounded by various gases. Okay, our Earth is being surrounded by various gases. So this envelope of gases we call it as atmospheric, or we can call it as air. We are surrounded by air around us. The lower boundary of the atmospheric pressure is the ground surface or the sea, and the upper boundary somewhere lying around 10,000 kilometers. Okay, so this atmosphere is being held by gravitational force of the Earth. The gravity holds the atmosphere on the Earth surface or surrounding the Earth. Now see here, atmospheric pressure. Now we'll be discussing pressure exerted by the air. Okay. By gravity, this atmosphere is being held. Now, as we go up in the atmosphere pressure, as we go up in the atmosphere, the pressure decreases. The density of air decreases. So near the Earth's surface, the air is more dense. As we go up, as the altitude increases, as the height increases, please don't check there anything. Please don't put.
Page number,
you better know, it's 13th chapter, 109 page. 13th chapter. So, as we know, the air exerts pressure. So, near the surface, air will be more dense as compared to the pressure air at higher altitude. Okay, as height increases, pressure decreases. So, near the surface, there will be more dense air. Density is more. As we go up, the density decreases. Air expands. The air molecules, they are becoming more and more far apart as we move up in the atmosphere. Okay? Near the surface, they are more closer. More dense they are, more pressure will be there. Okay? So, atmospheric pressure, how it varies with altitude? There are factors which affect the atmospheric pressure. So, first factor is the altitude. We'll be discussing altitude. With height, how the atmospheric pressure varies. So near the surface, more the atmospheric pressure will be there because air is more dense. Air is more dense, more molecules are present in smaller space. But as altitude increases, the density decreases, air expands. So density increases, pressure decreases. So with altitude, we have to remember that atmospheric pressure, as altitude increases, atmospheric pressure increases. As altitude decreases, as altitude increases, atmospheric pressure decreases. They are inversely related. They are inversely proportional. So As height increases, atmosphere pressure decreases. As height increases, atmosphere pressure decreases. You have to remember this one. With altitude, atmospheric pressure decreases. This is the first factor which affects the atmospheric pressure, that is altitude. This is clear? Now, second is?
Yes, sir.
Temperature. How atmospheric pressure varies with temperature. Okay. Now, see here. As the temperature increases, air expands. Air expands, the pressure will be less. It is inversely related with temperature. High temperature, low pressure, low atmospheric pressure. Low temperature, high atmospheric pressure. Now you can see here as well, air, if you take the air, with as temperature increases, this air will expand. The air will expand. Its pressure decreases. Its pressure decreases. So hot air, it rises up because it is having less pressure as compared to the surrounding region. So air, as it gets heated, as temperature increases, it expands, its pressure increases, so hot air rises. Okay. Now see here, any air, as it cools down, as air cools down, it contracts. As air cools down, it contracts. As it contracts, it becomes more dense. As it becomes more dense, its pressure increases and it will sink down. It will sink down towards the surface of Earth. So temperature is clear. So atmospheric pressure is inversely related with temperature. Temperature increases, atmospheric pressure decreases. So at any place of the Earth where there is high temperature, there will be low atmospheric pressure. Okay. We can take example as well. Okay. So here we have the poles, North Pole, South Pole, and here we have the equator. Sun rays, the insolation. It is insolation, not isolation. Insolation. Incoming solar radiation. Remember this. Most of the students are writing isolation. Isolation is different, isolating the things. It is insolation, incoming solar radiation. So incoming solar radiation to the Earth, the coming radiation to the Earth, they are called insolation. So most of the heat is concentrated on the equatorial region. Most of the heat is concentrated in the equatorial region. So there will be high temperature here. Okay. Whereas very less heat reaches the poles. So as we move from equator towards the pole, the heat coming from the sun decreases. The insolation decreases. Heat received by the Earth decreases. So there is latitudinal imbalance. More heat is concentrated on the equator, near the equator. As you move towards the poles, the amount of heat decreases. Okay. So these regions will be cold. This will be hotter regions, hot regions, equatorial regions. So equator, high temperature is there, high temperature. Here will be low pressure. On the poles, it will be cold, low temperature, high pressure will be developed here. So what will happen, see here. So for time being, forget about the rotation of the Earth. For example, Earth is not rotating. So what will happen? So see here, high temperature will be there, more heat received from the sun. So what will happen? The air available, it will get heated. It will get heated, more heated. Now it expands. So low pressure is developed here. So low pressure near the equator will develop. Low pressure, the air gets heated, it expands, then it will rise. It starts to rise. So it moves up. It rises up. Okay, in the atmosphere. Now here one more thing I'll tell you. When I say lower atmosphere, it means near the surface. Upper atmosphere means near the tropopause. Because we have studied most of the weather phenomena do take place in troposphere, a little bit in stratosphere. So here, all the weather phenomena will be concentrated to troposphere. So whenever I say upper atmosphere, that means near the tropopause, in the troposphere only. In this chapter, we'll be confined to troposphere. We'll be discussing only one layer of Earth, that is troposphere. So our study will be confined to troposphere only. Lower atmosphere means near the Earth's surface, upper atmosphere means near the tropopause, in troposphere, okay? So what will happen? The air will rise. Now, as air rises, it expands and it cools down in the upper atmosphere. It cools down in the upper atmosphere. Now, and what is happening here? Here the air becomes cold. Here, very less heat has reached. So low temperature means air will be cold. Air will be more dense. So high pressure will be here. And because of high pressure here and low pressure here. So whenever there is a difference in pressure, what happens? The wind starts to flow. Whenever there is a difference in pressure, wind starts to flow from high pressure to low pressure. So from poles, it moves towards the equator. Take the place of this rising air. Now, what will happen to this air? It gets cold and it moves towards the pole. You can see one cycle is being generated here. This is one cell. Its name is Hadley cell. Okay. So what happens? Here the hot air, it rises up, it expands, it rises up, it cools down in the upper atmosphere. Now, and from here, high pressure is developed on the poles. The air, it moves towards the equator. And this air takes the place of this moving air. This is how one cell is formed. Now see here, what does this air circulation does? It is transferring heat from the equator towards the pole. Cold air is coming towards it, getting heated, rises up, then moving towards the pole, getting cooled down again. So this is how the winds transfer the heat. Okay, differential heating is there because of the sun. Because of insulation, there is differential heating on the Earth's surface, and to moderate that or to decrease that differential heating. The winds helps in this. As well, ocean currents modify the temperature. So what will happen? This cold winds moves towards here, get heated. It rises up and again, it gets cooled down, moves towards the pole. This is how circulation is taking place. Air circulation. This circulation takes place when there is no rotation of the Earth. Because of rotation of the Earth, it gets modified. The circulation gets modified a little bit. That we'll be discussing afterwards. Okay. This thing is clear. Okay. Now we discuss one term, pressure gradient. Gradient means slope. Slope of pressure. So see here. Here we have discussed that from high pressure to low pressure, wind flows from high pressure to low pressure. So what does pressure gradient means? So see here, due to differential heating, different places on the Earth, they are heated differently. Since they are heated differently, there will be difference in the temperature of these places. Due to difference in temperature of these places, there will be difference in pressure generated. So for example, here we have A place, here B place. Here high temperature, here low temperature. So low temperature being here, so high pressure will be here. And here will be low pressure. And wind blows from high pressure to low pressure. So wind starts to blow from low pressure to high pressure to low pressure to nullify that pressure difference. Okay, to nullify that pressure difference or to decrease that pressure difference. Okay, so now pressure, it is being represented by isobars on map. What is isobars? Bar is the unit of pressure. Iso means same. So we connect all the places having the same pressure. So for example, this is one isobar around the B place. So all the points on this line will have the same pressure. all the points on this line will have the same pressure. Similarly, so for example, here high pressure, then here high, a little bit less pressure, pressure is decreasing. Okay, so what will happen? Air will blow from here like this. It will be perpendicular to the isobars. The air flow will be perpendicular to the isobar, or our pressure gradient will be perpendicular to the isobars. So what does pressure gradient means? Pressure gradient means change in pressure, the rate of change in pressure per unit distance. With respect to distance, how the pressure is changing, that is pressure gradient. So pressure gradient provides us the rate at which the pressure is changing with respect to distance. Okay, if pressure gradient is very high, it is, or it is very steep. If the pressure gradient is very high or very steep, it means the pressure is, there is very huge difference in the pressure. Pressure changes taking very fast. If it is very steep, that means the pressure changes taking very fast per unit distance. If it is very gentle, the slope is very gentle, or very low value of pressure gradient, that means the pressure changes less with respect to the distance. Okay. Now, if pressure gradient is very steep, then the what kinds of winds will flow? Winds flow, the speed, the velocity of the winds will be very fast. There will be very strong winds. The velocity of the winds will be very fast. Okay, if pressure gradient is more, that is change in pressure is very high with respect to unit distance. Okay, if pressure gradient is gentle, so change in pressure will be very less. So which kinds of winds will be flowing? The velocity will be very less. Velocity is less of winds, okay? So if there is high pressure gradient, if pressure gradient is steep, very steep, therefore strong winds will flow. If pressure gradient is gentle, very less, then winds velocity will be less. Very weak winds will flow, or gentle winds will flow. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Till now we have discussed atmosphere pressure and how it varies with altitude, how it varies with temperature, that we have discussed. Okay. Then the cell we have discussed, isobars, pressure gradient we have discussed. So now it's clear how the winds flow.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now there's one more. Rotation of the earth. There is one more factor affecting air pressure, rotation of the earth. So see here what happens. As the earth rotates, what will happen? Air will be pushed outward. You've seen yourself, if you are on the merry-go-round, you are pushed outward. If it starts to rotate, you are pushed outward. Similarly here, the air is being pushed outward. Okay? So high pressure develops here, and because the because of rotation of the earth, the air on the poles is pushed outward. So you can see as the air on the poles, it is pushed outward, it starts to expand because it spreads out over larger area. So air pressure starts to decrease. You can see air is concentrated here. Now as it starts to spread out, so it will be spreading out in larger area, and air pressure, it expands, and therefore air pressure decreases as the air spreads out. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
Temperature, rotation. Okay. There are more factors with rotation of the earth. That is Coriolis force we have discussed. And its effect as well we have discussed. And there is Farrell's law. Okay. These three we'll be discussing afterwards as well. Okay. I'm skipping these three things for time being. Coriolis force, its effects, and the Farrell law. Okay. We'll discuss when we discuss the trade winds. Okay. When we discuss the wind system, we'll discuss these three. Okay. For time being, we are leaving these. Okay. Okay, atmospheric pressure we have discussed. Now we'll be discussing pressure bells. Okay, before that we have discussed the temperature zones. Since atmospheric pressure depends on temperature, therefore the atmospheric pressure belts will be marked on the basis of the temperature zones. So here I draw the temperature zones. Which were the temperature zones? Here we have the 0 degree equator, then the tropics, Tropic of Cancer,
Tropic of Capricorn,
Tropic of Capricorn. 23.5 degrees, 23.5 degrees south, it is north, 90 degrees, and the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle. 66 degrees north.
66.5
South Pole is Antarctic Circle. This is Arctic Circle. Okay, so we have discussed which zone is this one. Between the tropics, we have the torrid zone. We have the torrid zone or the tropical zone. Okay, most of the heat is concentrated in the torrid zone. Okay, then we have the temperate zone.
Temperate zone.
These are the frigid zones. Okay. We can see the latitudinal difference. Imbalance we can see. More heat is concentrated near the equator. As you move away from the equator, the temperature decreases. Okay. Now, pressure belts I draw. See here. If there would have been no rotation of the Earth, only two pressure belts would have been there. That is near the equator. Since high temperature is near the equator, here will be low pressure belt or high pressure?
Low pressure belt.
Low pressure belt. And this pressure belt is called as equatorial
pressure belt.
Low pressure belt. This is clear. Now see here how much it is. 5 degrees of the equator. 5 degrees north, 5 degrees south, of the equator. So it is around 10 degrees. Okay. It may vary, but it is nearly around 10 degrees belt. Okay. 5 degrees north of the equator, 5 degrees south of the equator. This is our equatorial low pressure belt. Here we have the low pressure. Okay. So in torrid region, see here on the basis of temperature zones, we can mark the pressure belts. This is clear. Now other pressure belt will be here. Around 75 degrees, beyond the 75 degrees north. North Pole here as well. Give a minute.
South Pole.
So 75 degrees south, here we have South Pole. So this will be which pole? Here will be high pressure or low pressure?
High.
See, temperature is very low there. So it will be high pressure.
High pressure. This
we call as polar high. Polar high, we usually call this is high pressure. Polar high. This is polar high. These two are polar high. If there would have been no rotation of the Earth, only these pressure belts would have been there. That is equatorial low pressure belt, polar high, polar high. Now the winds will be flowing from high pressure towards low pressure, then moving back in the upper atmosphere towards the pole. So circulation would be like this. Here the wind rises up in upper atmosphere, it goes down, and in this wind being at high pressure, it moves towards
the low pressure.
So this would have been the circulation if there would have been no rotation of the Earth. Okay. But because of rotation of the Earth, more pressure belts are developed in between. Two more pressure belts. Okay. So again, next is subtropical, that is around 30 degrees. Next is around 60 degrees. 30 degrees south, 60 degrees south. So here we have, this is subtropical high pressure belt. This is subtropical high pressure belt. Subtropical high pressure belt. 5 degrees, again 35 degrees north and 25 degrees south. So 10 degrees again. Similarly, here we have in the southern hemisphere. This is subtropical. Okay, I mark with red. This is subtropical high pressure belt. Okay. So we have in the northern hemisphere as well in southern hemisphere, we have the subtropical high pressure belt. Okay. Now around 60 degrees, we have one more. So it may be 65 or 66 and a half degree, you can mark here 55 degrees. North and north, okay. Here as well. Okay. Here we have 55 degrees south, 66 and a half degrees south. This is our
subpolar high pressure, low pressure belt.
Or it is subpolar or temperate. Okay, we can call temperate as well, temperate high pressure belt, a low pressure belt, or subpolar. Low pressure belt. Here as well, subpolar or temperate as well, we can call it. Subpolar low pressure belt. Okay, now see here. Near the equator, we have equatorial low pressure belt. On the poles, we have the polar high. Okay, now in between two as well. Low, then high, then low, then high. Is this clear? Equatorial low pressure belt, subtropical high pressure belt. So polar, subpolar, low pressure belt, or temperate, low pressure belt. Then we have the polar high. Okay. So we have alternatively low belt, high pressure. Now this means earlier only two belts were there. So wind was flowing in one cell. Now see here, wind will be flowing in how many cells in northern hemisphere? 1, 2, 3 cells. Okay, how it will be flowing? From high pressure, so see here, low pressure, the wind rises. Now, high pressure from here, wind comes, and one circulation will be like this. Now, here what will happen? Okay, leave the center one once. This is indirect cell. Okay, leave it for time. Now, see here, here high pressure, here low pressure. So, wind rises here, moves. This is clear. Now, this cell is being powered by these two cells. So here wind is here. It is sinking. So here as well, wind will be sinking. Here wind will be rising. So this cell will be like this. So three cells are there, this line. This is because of rotation of the earth, three cells are formed. Okay. This is Hadley cell, Farrell cell. This is indirect. This is Farrell cell. I think, okay, I'll see that. Indirect cell, okay. Three cells are there now. If there would have been no rotation, only one cell. Similarly, three cells in southern hemisphere. Is this clear now? How the wind will be flowing? This is in lower atmosphere, this is in upper atmosphere. This is near the surface, this is near the tropopause, okay. So, what is happening? Equatorial low pressure belt, more heat is concentrated here. The air expands, low air pressure, low pressure develops here, and winds from the surrounding rushes towards the low pressure. Is this clear? How winds is rushing? See here, if low pressure is developed here and high pressure is surrounding it, if it is low pressure, what will happen? Wind will move towards the low pressure. From the surrounding, wind will blow towards the low pressure. And here, wind gets heated, it moves up. It moves up in the atmosphere. This is clear? So what is happening here? Low pressure is developed here. Wind gets heated, it rises up. Now the wind from the surrounding rushes towards the low pressure belt. And a cyclone is formed. Okay? So wind is rushing out. And what is happening here in the upper atmosphere? Wind gets cooled down and it expands. It moves away. Winds get cooled down, it moves away. So it's spreading out. Here anticyclone is formed. Here cyclone, in the upper atmosphere, anticyclone. And here what is happening? Cyclone is forming, here anticyclone. Here cyclone, here anticyclone. Is this clear? And here always anticyclone is formed. Because wind is rushing out, moving away, spreading out from the high pressure. If high pressure is there, what will happen? Wind will move away, spread out. Okay. So, in the lower atmosphere, what will happen? Wind will flow from high pressure to low pressure. This will be happening. Here I am neglecting Coriolis force, okay? For time being, I am neglecting Coriolis force, okay? So what will happen? From subtropical high pressure, wind will blow towards the equatorial region. And what will happen here? From this high pressure, wind will blow from subpolar low pressure belt. And from here, wind will flow from for the low pressure belt. Okay? Coriolis force, we have Coriolis effect, we are neglecting for time being, okay? This is how the winds will flow, yes or no? From high to low. This is how the winds will flow. From the subtropical high pressure belt, they will move towards the equator, then rises up, then moves back. This is how the circulation will be taking place. And here, this is how the circulation will be taking place. And here, this is how the circulation will be taking place, the wind system. Is this clear?
Now, yes, sir.
Now, because of Coriolis effect, what will happen to the winds? In Northern Hemisphere, what will happen to these winds? If wind is flowing from pole towards equator, in Northern Hemisphere, it will be deflected towards its
right.
Towards its right. So that is Ferrel's law. Ferrel's law says that any fluid or any object which is moving from pole towards the equator, it will be deflected towards it right. So what will happen? These will be deflected towards its right. So this will be the actual path taken by the wind. Yes or no? This will be the actual path taken by the winds, okay? And in here, what will happen in this region? They will be deflected towards the right. So they are moving this direction. So towards the right, this will be the direction. Okay? And what about these winds? These will be in this direction. Is this clear? And in Southern Hemisphere, the winds will be deflected towards there. In Southern Hemisphere, winds will be deflected towards right or left. Towards left, that is Ferrel's law. In Northern Hemisphere, they deflect towards right. In Southern Hemisphere, they deflect towards left. So here, the wind will be in this direction. Okay, towards left. Is this clear? So, how yes, the winds sir. Are blowing? In this direction. These winds are blowing in this direction. These winds are blowing in this direction. Now, if we discuss the equatorial low pressure belt, okay, what is happening at equatorial low pressure belt? There is high temperature. There is high temperature and low pressure. What are the characteristics of equatorial low pressure belt? There is high temperature here, low pressure. air rises up. Air gets heated, low pressure develops, and air rises up. Now see here, as temperature of air rises, it holds more moisture. So here the air will be more humid. It will be holding more moisture. Now as the air rises at the equatorial belt, what will happen? It cools down. As it cools down, what will happen? It starts to rain. So therefore, here the rain will fall in the equatorial region. So air rises. It contains more moisture. Hot air contains more moisture. It takes the moisture from the oceans. It contains more moisture. As it rises, it cools down. So convectional rainfall takes place. Convectional rainfall takes place in the equatorial region. And so here will be thunderstorm. Variation in the weather will be more. There will be more variation in the weather. Thunderstorm will take place. Strong winds will flow in this region. Okay. And this region is mainly called as doldrums. This region is mainly called as doldrums. Because here, since very high temperatures, there very humid conditions are there. So the sailors used to get becalmed here. Gloomy, kind of gloomy or listless mood they used to get. Okay. So these are called as doldrums. Okay. This belt is also called as doldrums. Okay. Now, tropical high pressure belt. What happens here? This is the region of descending airs. Air is sinking. So what is happening? As air is sinking, as air sinks, it cools down. It's cool air sinks down. It should be dry air. Dry air. So here what happens? This is the region of sinking air. So this region is mainly of calm environment or calm weather. There will be very low or no wind flowing in this region because wind is descending. Descending winds are very cool and dry. They are very cool and dry, and there will be very less variation in the weather here. So here, as there is no wind flowing or very little wind flowing, the sailors, when they used to sail using the wind system, their sails won't make their ships to move. So what they used to do? They used to throw out the cargo in the sea, in the oceans, so that their ship becomes light and it can move. It can move with the help of the wind. So mainly in those times, main cargo was horses. So they used to throw the horses in water. They used to throw the horses in water, and so that ship becomes light and it can move. So these latitudes are mainly called as, these tropical high pressure is called as horse latitudes. They are called as horse latitudes. This is clear. These are called as doldrums. Reason we already discussed. These are called as horse latitudes. We already discussed. Is this clear? And subpolar low pressure belt. Okay. Mainly these two pressure belts are developed because of rotation of the earth. Because of rotation of the earth, these two pressure belts are developed. Okay. So earlier, this air, it must, while in the upper, it moved towards the polar region. But because of rotation of the earth, it sinks at the subtropical high pressure belt. It sinks in between. Okay. Similarly here, as the air is spreading out, because of rotation of the earth, air is spreading out. And because of that, here low pressure is developed. This low pressure, subpolar low pressure belt is not much pronounced because it lies in the colder regions, temperature is low. So it's a very weak low pressure belt. Mainly we can see it in winters. Sometimes summers, mostly this vanishes. Okay. Or its effect is very, very less. It's a very weak in summer. This is clear. So revise all what you have discussed. These polar high, all the pressure belts, and next lecture we'll be discussing shifting of pressure belt. Now we'll afterwards. Okay, shifting is not at present. Okay, so go through these all pressure belts and revise. If you have any doubt, you can ask now. In next lecture, we'll be discussing the wind systems. Okay, these are the one of the wind system: trade winds, westerlies, polar easterlies. Okay, we'll be discussing these winds in next lecture. Any doubt you have, you can ask.
Thank you, sir.
Doubt, thank you, sir.
Okay, I tried. Okay. Have you started doing your project work?
Sir, completed.
Try to complete it as soon as possible, okay? Within these 10 to 15 days, try to complete this one, okay?
Sir, completed and sent the pictures also.
Okay, there's no need of sending the pics of that. That has to be submitted at school. So I'll give you a time period around 15 days or 20 days to submit at school, okay? Okay, so revise whatever we have studied. In next lecture, we'll be discussing wind system of the earth. In that, we'll be discussing these planetary winds. And afterwards, we'll move to seasonal winds or the POD winds. Then we'll discuss the local winds. Okay, this is most important. The planetary winds, they are the most important ones. Okay, have you understood these all we have discussed? So please go through it. And if you have a doubt, you can ask in next lecture, okay? Okay, then thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
And, please put your name correctly. No TH.
Thank you, sir.